how we one should plan to conduct these studies so that you have the right objective being addressed when you are testing the disinfectants. So as I said in my early part of the talk, that the viruses fall into two categories. They are enveloped viruses and the non-enveloped viruses. So the enveloped viruses have a lipid bilayer which encompasses the protein coat. So in the slide, I have the structure of the virus as well depicted so that people can refer to what I'm talking about. The enveloped viruses are vulnerable to environment like humidity, osmotic pressure, temperatures, pH. Parameters of contact time should be taken into consideration and their vulnerability to the temperatures. So these are some of the characteristics one has to keep in mind when you're designing about evaluating the efficacy of the disinfectant. Likewise, for non-enveloped viruses which do not contain the lipid bilayer and they just have the genetic material being surrounded by the protein coat, the viruses become much more resistant and they tend to persist in the environment for over a long time and they sustain over there, and they can sustain in the harsh environments as well. So, which includes the extreme pH conditions, the exposure to UV lights, high temperature, as well as the high or low adverse pH conditions. So, when we are designing the virucidal efficacy studies, we need to take into consideration that for which kind of viruses are the ones that can be tested on, and do the same disinfectant have a good efficacy against both enveloped and non-enveloped viruses.